Hey guys, this is KG for you, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is Alpha 12, Season 12. We're in Episode 4, and this is the first video that I've done on this game in a week, because I was on vacation last week. But I'm back at it, and I've got some strats in mind. I've got some ways to like help my self in the game. I've also went into the options menu and turned up all of the visual fidelity options, so the game should look a lot better. One of the tips you guys gave me that is coming incredibly handy is that with my game settings. Now, first of all, this is 12.1, so I did read the patch notes, but I didn't see anything about this being changed. So, as far as I understand it, the zombies stop running at 0000, and they start running at 0000, and they stop running at 6 a.m. So we're going to test that out in this video. And right now, what I want to do is I need some more of the wood frames. So we're going to come right in here and go ahead and craft us up some wood frames. Let's see, frame. I am not a big fan of crafting out of this right-click menu at all. I think it's pretty terrible. It might be good for new players, but I don't really need it. But what I do like about this kind of stuff is the way you can repair stuff out of the right menu. I can't repair this item because I don't have what I need for it. It even tells you exactly how many metal strips you need. That's cool. I didn't even know that. So what I've got here is I've got my best weapon, which is a iron reinforced club, and as you can tell, it's pretty damaged. I've got my second best weapon, which is a poor iron reinforced club, which is actually doing more entity damage than this one now, so I'm gonna use that one. And then a backup will be a faulty wood club. Now, I have a regular wood club. What am I doing? Let's repair that. And let's put that up here. Can we? Yeah. You know, we could do with that other one, we can burn it, just to get it out of here. I should also burn the shiv, too. You can't do anything with the shiv, I'm just gonna drop it on the ground or something. So, alright, I've got a couple strats here. First of all, 12.1 did not require a restart, which I'm very thankful for. Second of all, I want to live in this house right here. Apparently there is a forge in that house. That is gonna be my home. We need to clear it out, okay? So what I'm going to do is I've got a couple strategies I can try and implement. The first strategy is I'm going to make spiked wood spikes. Now, I don't know how these are going to work. They've been pretty crappy in the past, but they're going to be better than using the bow. Now, here's the thing with the bow. You guys all told me the bow, you know, I've heard a lot of information everywhere from the bow takes 12 hits to kill a zombie, to the bow takes 2 hits to kill a zombie, to the zombies' hitboxes have been, their hitboxes on their heads have been changed. As a matter of fact, Alpha 12.1, they did something different where they kind of like made like a neck area, because apparently if you were shooting the zombie's head and it went between the head and the torso, the arrows would go right through the neck and not do any damage. I've heard a lot of stuff, guys. Keep the tips coming, but just so you know, a lot of this stuff is kind of misinformed, but who knows what's true and what's not. Let's get up there and see what we got going on here. A lot of you didn't like me living underground. Some of you told me, oh yeah, go make a base underground. I'm gonna go in between. I'm gonna live underground until I can live up top, basically, is what I'm looking at right now. We got some snow, so that's pretty sweet. And let's go right here and put, this is the house we want. I'm thinking we're gonna make a kill zone right here. And what I'm gonna do is I have two ways I can deal with a kill zone for these zombies. Number one, I'm going the wrong way, there we go. Number one, I can just put down the spikes and hope they kill themselves. The nice part about these spikes is they don't do a ton of damage, but they'll break easily, so I don't have to do any cleanup after everything's done, which is really nice. The other thing I can do, and a lot of you guys have given me some tips on how to use these spikes, and I really appreciate it. But one thing I could do is I was thinking about making a 3x3 like pillar about 4 or 5 blocks high, all right, and surrounding it with the good wooden spikes, upgraded and everything. And then I would take the frames that I have and put them in a little stair formation to get up. Let's get warmed up here, guys. Let's get warmed up. One thing about fighting these zombies that you have to do that I was not doing earlier is you really have to be mindful of your stamina. If you don't have a lot of stamina, and I knew this last time I played, I just didn't think about it. If you don't have a lot of stamina, not only are you not going to do a lot of damage, but they're not going to get knocked back. That knockback is based off your stamina. So that's another thing I was not thinking about earlier. So we're just going to hit this guy in the face. Crack. And he's down. Very good. Oh, we're still using our crappy one. Let's use this one. Anywho, so anyway. So I put, so what I want to do is, should I try and kill that? Nah, let's leave the deer alone. So what I want to do is I want to have like a 3x3 pillar of wood, fully upgraded and about 4 or 5 blocks high. Then you put the spikes around it, upgrade the spikes, and then you take the wood frames and build a temporary wood frame way to get up into the, up into the house. And basically, not up into the house, but up onto the blocks. And then you gather all the zombies in the area. And then you, and now this is very early game stuff, guys. These are very early game strategies. Like when you don't have a good bow or a good weapon to kill stuff, this is ways you can clear out an area where, you know, you're not going to get experience with the zombies, which kind of sucks, but at least it can clear out a town for you. And, sorry, I'm concentrating here. I don't want to get hit. It could clear out a town for you and give you an opportunity to start looting stuff, which is what you really want. Another tip people gave me is, Cage, you're not picking up all the cotton. Why don't you pick up all the cotton and make some armor? And that is a great tip. I'm definitely going to do that soon. Not right now, though. So what we're doing is we're looking for ways to clear out areas that don't include having quality weapons, which you're not going to have in the beginning of the game. This game's not meant for you to just come in and start killing zombies. That was my mistake. I came in, and if I couldn't clear out a town of zombies, I got upset. And I was like, man, I really want to clear out a town of zombies, and I couldn't do it. And I was like, well, what now? Well, you got to innovate. You got to do things a little different. So that's what I'm going to be doing. Should be chopping down some more trees as well. I don't have a stone. Let's pick up a stone. And repair you. And put you right there. That is fine. And let's start cutting down some trees. There's also a really quick way to level up. My buddy Games for Kicks, who I do videos with on Ark, came up with a really cool leveling system where you make wooden, like, railings, and it gets you an insane amount of experience. I think he figured out something like, if you had 2,000 logs or 2,400 logs or something like that, you would probably get enough experience to, like, get to level 60. Now, I might be mistaken on the math there, but it was a lot of experience he was getting. That much I do know. Alright, let's chop down some more trees. We're going to need a lot of wood for this. So that's going to give you the experience you need to make a better bow. I don't know if I like the idea of wasting feathers. If I like the idea of wasting feathers on regular arrows. I think I might save my feathers. We should go over here and check this out. This will be a good warm-up for our defensive system. Let's go ahead and make a... Now, let's just take these wood spikes and see how this works. I don't want to make extra wood spikes. This isn't going to work. So what you would do is you'd gather around. Actually, you know what? I could probably take these guys out melee style. A lot of people said sneak around. That's an option. You could sneak around. I'm not a sneaker. I'm not good at it, and I don't like doing it. So I like to go in there and kill zombies. It makes it a little tougher for me. You know, fair enough, but it's just the way I like to. It's just the way I roll. There you are. You know what, as a little test, she should walk around these. You could just kind of... Oh, okay, so she just broke them. So that one zombie, one regular zombie, broke one of these. So let's see how many it takes to kill her. Alright, two of those are broken. You know what, these might not be viable. As a matter of fact, we should probably stop playing games here. No, they're not even... They don't even look like they're damaging her. Alright, we're getting surrounded here. Let's, yeah, these are no good. These aren't really useful. And we're gathering a crowd. What I'd like to do is kind of... Let me bring them over here. The problem is the grass is making it hard to put these down. Yeah, she broke two of these on her own. That's incredibly weak. That's even weaker than I thought they would be. But hold on, let me see what I can do here. Alright, I placed them all down. Yeah, they're not even dying. I think she died on them. Alright, so one did die. It's just, I don't know. I think I like my other strategy better. Although, you know what it is? It weakens them, so you could kill them in one shot, maybe. These guys drop something. Whoa, careful. I don't know. Maybe they're not that useless. And they're really going to help you with the big zombies, because if you don't have that bow rocking for you... By the way, the crossbow still is overpowered as ever. I expect that to be nerfed in an upcoming, you know, patch. But yeah, I mean, this works. A little slower, but... A little slower. Let's get Fatty on there. You know what? This isn't terrible. This isn't terrible. It might not kill all of them, but it's... You know, they do walk over them. I was afraid they were going to avoid them. Alright, Fatty, walk over those. Walk over those. He's walking under the gore block, so it's slowing him down. Look at him walking around him. He won't walk around him forever. Eventually, he'll just walk through them. Okay. Alright. Alright. Somewhat effective, guys. Somewhat effective. Not sure how much I enjoy it, though. Maybe. Maybe. It's, you know, it's a good thing to do if you don't have the firepower to kill some zombies. These are crap. I want to just take them to get them out of here. Actually, that shotgun one isn't crap. How are we doing now? Doing okay. The other guys don't even know I'm here. Well, they're going to know I'm here now. Let's leave that there for now. Ooh, that's not bad. That's not bad. Another thing that is pretty good is... These, ooh, you get three out of... Did I get, like... Oh, that's right. This one was crap. I don't particularly like the bone shiv. I don't feel like it has enough of range as I like, but it's still pretty good. Now what we're doing right here is we're getting cloth for clothes. We got over here nothing. Is he stuck up there or something? I don't know. Whatevs. I gotta chop down some more trees. That should be good enough for now. I can always come back. I don't have to do all this right now. Can you break these up? Oh, you can. Cool. I won't right now, though. I heard a bear. The bear is a problem. We ran into a bear on my multiplayer game with Autumn, and the damn thing wouldn't aggro me until I, like, smacked it. So, that was pretty weird. All right, let's just go this way. Cut the, although, I think this is where I heard the bear. Part of the Alpha 12.1 patch was that they made the bear spawns a lot less. Oh, by the way, you might notice whenever I chop down a tree, I kind of back up. That was a lesson hard learned on my multiplayer series with Autumn. I had a tree roll down a hill and kill me. So that was a little a lesson learned. Stay away from the trees, guys. Need some more stone. Okay. All right, we're doing much better here. Starting to get my feet are my legs underneath me. When I made my my three videos on this and my three videos on bottom, I made those back to back to back to back to back to back, like six videos in a row. So it was quite a challenge, no doubt. I'm wondering if I want to make stone arrows. I guess I will. They're not that great, but I don't know when I'm gonna get like iron tipped arrows. You do find some, but not a lot. I hear something coming in. Oh, it's a horde. Well, you know what? I don't really want to deal with that right now. So let's get out of here. I have a feeling that horde's going to walk right by my base, though. I'm going the wrong way. No, let's go this way. Gotta get to the kill zone. All right, let's get our stamina back. Remember, and this might be my biggest downfall in this alpha so far, is that I don't wait for my stamina to come back in melee fights. See, this thing doesn't have the range. I don't like the range on this. Yeah, I really don't like the range on this. You know what? I think I'll stick with my clubs. And what's the entity damage? Oh, 7.68? That's... I don't know. Check out that horde. Get out of there. It looks like they might have walked right by where my kill zone is gonna be. So what do you think, guys? You think I should stick with the small spikes or just make my big spike? See, my big spike thing is gonna take it might not take a lot more wood. Maybe. Let's by the way, thank you. Shift right click splits in half. So that's pretty sweet. And then we will make frames. How many frames is 3 by 3 by 3? That's 9 9 9 9 times 4. I'm not good with math. 36. I need more of these. Yeah, that should be enough. Am I close to the... Oh, I'm right by the kill zone. Alright. This will be the kill zone. Oh! Hold up. We're going for that. Maybe. Oh, are we back on not being able to see the planes? Oh, jeez. Alright. I don't even see that, so... Forget it. Okay. We on the road? I can't really tell. I think we're on the road. Yeah, we are. Would this be a good spot for the kill zone? Nah, let's head up the road. We'll do it closer to the house. Oh, is this not the house? I thought this is where the house was. Where's that house? Oh, I'm sorry. It was over here. My bad. Let's head over there. That was just a campsite. There's the house right there. Set up the kill zone right outside. I want to move into this house pretty quickly. Bear. This is the house, isn't it? No, this isn't the house. No, this is definitely not the house. Although there will be a forge in there. But that's not the... Where's the... Oh, it's this one. Okay, don't worry, guys. I'll get there eventually. There it is. That's the house. Yes. Yes, sir. I will live there. Okay, I hear the zombies spawning. So we're definitely going to... We're going to find a somewhat flat area and set up the kill zone. I'm probably not going to have time to. I may have to run these guys off a little bit. Let's go this way. I think the road's up here. I want to do the kill zone on the road. And I have no stamina. Darn it. Okay. Wait, that won't go on the ground? Yeah, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. That's fine. We're going to have to run these guys off a little bit, though, because I'm not... I don't have time to set it up. Oh. They're not coming at us in that big a force. Maybe we could take them out. A lot of times when I'm fighting, guys, I'm going to have to stop talking because I need to hear what's going on behind me. Especially for bears. Okay. We're gonna lure these guys back around here. I don't want to go up the road and pull more zombies. Watch the stamina. Watch the stamina. You know, we're probably not gonna have to set up the kill zone. Although I wish I kind of made some small spikes. You know, we could still do that. I don't want to make that many. Ooh, you will die. Darn it. Okay. I think I made more spikes than I wanted to, but that's okay. I probably don't need to do this as much as I feel like I am, but I'm kind of just showing you a way that you can kill the zombies when you start off if your weapons are garbage. Also, instead of hitting them two or three times, now you only have to hit them once if they walk over those spikes. Oh, we got too close there. See, it's not gonna kill them, but it's gonna give you a bit of an edge. There you go. There you go. This guy's becoming a problem. Okay. Bring you around here. Walk you right through there. Keep an eye out. We're okay. And he just killed himself. Alright, guys. You know what? I'm a fan of the small spikes in the early parts of the game. And I would really recommend you guys deal with this if you're having problems. Grain alcohol is nice. Also, something cool about the spikes is sometimes they'll walk around them. So if, like, you're surrounded, you can, like, kind of turn your back to the spikes a little bit, and it gives you that extra little bit of time, you know? Very good. Very good. As a matter of fact, I'll load these up again in case I get overwhelmed. Now the problem is my clubs are starting to take some serious damage here. That's why these wooden clubs are so useful. Wooden clubs are not bad, guys. As a matter of fact, when I start off the game now, like from scratch, the first thing I would do if I were you is make 3 wooden clubs. And this big 3-pillar setup, you don't need it. I don't think you need it, personally. Okay. We'll pick stuff later. Let's clean out some zombies. I'd like to be staying here in a night or two. Just put spikes all around this bad boy. I'll figure out how I get in and out. But I think I have an idea. Hello. Okay, looking good. Now, where's this forge I heard so much about? Maybe it was the other cabin the forge was in. Nope, there's the forge. And a fireplace. Well, I don't really need a fireplace, but... Alright, looking good. Looking good. Leave my forge alone. Let's start rebuilding this thing. Well, should we rebuild it in wood, or should we try and do cobblestone? Can we do cobblestone? That's a good question. What do we need for cobblestone? Well, you can make the frames... cobblestone rocks are... Ooh, what is that? Lump of clay? What? Wow, okay. Well, you know what? Let's make cobblestone before we start fixing this place up. That's a piece of cake right there. I just have to find some clay, but, you know, not really a big deal. What's in here? Ooh, a toilet. We got some zombies outside. Let's not let them get us in here. Oh, this is a roaming horde. Oh, come on, guys. Come this way. Come on, horde. Come on over here. I'm just having fun with the spikes at this point. I could have left this horde alone. I made him. I might as well place him down, right? Alright, hold on, timer. I will not be calling this video in the middle of this. Have I looted this before? Nope. Look at them. Doing exactly what they're supposed to do. Slowing them down. Oh, these are great. These are working just exactly as I needed them to. Beautiful. Just trying to loot as many zombies as I can. Gotta make sure you loot the nurses. Alright. Walk over those, fatty. Alright, don't sprint anymore, Cage. Stamina's a little low, bro. Just get around like this. Looking around. Looking clear. Looking good. Alright, I've had enough of you. Now the gore blocks might cause some issues in this kill zone, but I'm not sure what they break the gore blocks with. Maybe the stone axe? Let's see. I know the gore blocks take longer to break now. Oh, that's not bad. That's not bad. You don't want to leave the gore blocks here, because they're going to mess up the whole kill zone. It looks like the gore blocks break up in two stages now. See, so yeah, you can right-click and drink and eat right out of your inventory? I love that. Oh, it's going to kill the deer for me. That'd be pretty sweet. Come on, deer. Let's see if we can make the deer run into the spikes. There we go! Sweet! Oh my god, I love the spikes! By the way, I don't need these bone chips anymore. I love the spikes. The spikes get the two thumbs up Cage guarantee of awesomeness. I love them. Now, I would like to continue looting. Let's go ahead and scrap. And scrap. And... oh, we've actually got some steel arrows. And some arrowheads. Alright, I do have this stuff. I mean, I should probably go home. I've got food on me. This has already been successful. Let's cut down a couple trees before we go home now. I will cut down the trees by my kill zone in case it becomes an issue. And then I'm going to go home. But I'm going to cut the video here. I totally forgot my timer went off. So that's going to be it for episode 4. And I'll see you next time for episode 5. Till then, take it easy.